Just let them go where he's in the
car.
For
me, it's really important what you're putting into your body. I love to start my day with a shake straight away, anchor A2 milk, plenty of fruit, nuts, all the good things. So I'm looking after myself. With anchor A2 milk, I can really feel the difference. The switch was when I tasted it for the first time.
And
it just feels better when I'm drinking it. It sets me up well for a really great day.
Suck. The sickest, vilest little bitch alive, aren't you, darling?
But this could be the year of getting into your new home. And you know who you'll thank?
Sick little bitch.
Set yourself up for 2021 with this great home loan rate from KiwiBank. You'll thank yourself.
Oh, if you want to change the channel, I don't mind.
What was I?
Oh, no.
Actually, I was thinking about that movie. And it just proves you can't, if you want to be successful in business, because his was a business, you don't employ family. Like his brothers, who had drugs in the car when he was travelling in it, which was a rule number one: you never let the product
Isn't the first one you don't use it yourself?
Well, yeah, and his brothers were, so they were getting themselves fucked up. And one was high on it and shot his girlfriend, so he turned informant.
Oh, that's right. I didn't realise it was one of his
and
brothers.
And his other brother had the drugs in the boot of the car when they went driving, which would have been a big no-no for him.
Well, that one was... He punched the life out of his brother and punched him, and he hit the... That was...
Well, that was because that was the brought a gun to his party and was high and started shooting people.
I think also maybe it was just a dumb idea... building your life on drugs.
Yeah. I suppose if you're gonna have a drug empire, you never let your family near it. Then if someone steps out of line, you can shoot them. You can't shoot your family.
Well, the Italians do it. Isn't that part of the problem about the mafia? They don't care who they shoot. You cross them, and it doesn't matter. Oh, please. But it would be very fascinating to actually look into the, like, that was obviously a Hollywood thing, and it'd be interesting to see what the reality of his story was.
Well, yeah, I was wondering whether it was a made-up true story or a true story.
Well, as far as I'm aware, they were passing that off as a
true story, eh?
Yeah, based on a true story. Internet's playing up.
It seems the latest thing the Republicans want to do is in the states like Pennsylvania and Arizona and New Georgia. They want us to change the voter laws. If you want to vote by mail, you'll have to send two emails beforehand with a photograph for ID. And then you'll have to get your vote notarized, and then you'll have to deliver it in hand. Or in, but yeah, you can't mail it in, you'll have to deliver it by hand.
You know about our rent increase?
Yeah.
I assume Wellington landlords will be using the justification, has rates gone up recently? Do you know if rates have gone up? Well, what's the justification for the rent increase?
Don't know. Well, increased cost, but I don't know what the increase in cost is. Costing them more to take their summer holidays in Switzerland.
I swear I've seen this before.
time I've ever been close to somebody who's died, so I cried a bit. I suppose the others were trying to be cool and sophisticated. I'm no good at that. I didn't like Richard that much. But when you act with someone, it makes a sort of bond. Probably like you and your sergeant. Is that silly?
No, I've heard silly things. What really happened in Edinburgh?
Sorry?
We've heard all sorts of half-baked accounts of your adventures at the festival. Sex and drugs and rock and roll, I dare say. Richard stealing from you all, getting thumped for his pains. What would it really matter?
It wasn't about sex or drugs. And I don't know for sure why it was important, but everybody went apeshit when Phil Benoit's laptop disappeared.
Phil being the one who sits in the corner watching everyone writing it all down.
5 minutes as well. I'm sorry. May I go to Venice now?
Of course. Have a nice time. Oh, Robbie. Did he tell you about Monkford?
Eventually. Do you know all the time?
He consulted me about whether to tell you and when.
That's thoughtful.
So you two still friends?
Interesting question. We're colleagues. Workmates and so on. No, don't swap comics every week. And he listens to weird music, but he's a damn good cop. He's just a bit young, I suppose. Enigmatic. He's private.
He says much the same about you.
That's ridiculous. There's nothing enigmatic about me.
So, tell me, honestly, are you okay?
Honest answer? I don't know. So just throw myself into your work. See if that makes me okay.
Just wanted to know a Eureka moment. Come to depend on it. I have. This is from Emma Goldman's dissertation. There is eminent men and very occasional women who dwell on Mount Olympus sharing profound philosophical reflections, invariably do so with their eyes looking upwards to heaven, whether they believe in its existence or not. Once in a while, why do they not cast their eyes downwards to the shanty towns and slums clustered at the foot of their blessed mountain from which flow their security and prosperity?
It takes a bright asteroid stuff like that. Mm-hmm. Where does Eureka come in?
Well, about a year and a half ago, Phil Beaumont wrote an article in the student newspaper saying that basically all life is shit. But it did end with the self-same paragraph about Mount Olympus.
Therefore what? Phil Beaumont helped Emma with her dissertation?
A couple?
Why not? What couples do?
What about if you wrote the entire thing?
An academic star who plans to run the country one day. Nobody stops that. The piece of work gave a lift off was not stolen.
Yeah, we don't know all the details yet, but it could be a valuable blackmailing weapon. Sorry, darling, you stole the whole thing, but I won't mention it again. You should have looked up in the post.
You recognize what Richard Scott did?
Possible.
Well, then Phil Beaumont. He knows what really happened. Why nobody murdering him?
Well, maybe he's careful.
Professor Gregson.
What about him?
Comes out that people have been awarded doctorates for other people's work, their career would soon start to unravel. Sergeant Nicholson called from Sheffield.
Oh yeah, that's his main bomb number. He wants you to call him back.
In the morning.
a reduced sentence. He should have been quiet. He's a piece of work, isn't he? He hit his wife in a hit and run, didn't he?
Sorry?
He hit his wife, killed his wife in a hit and run. Isn't that what happened? Oh, yes, please. Yummy, yummy. That's huge. Do you reckon it'll be nice cold?
Yeah.
I reckon that might be nice for breakfast. I'm going to have half. And maybe have some for breakfast or some later. I might make a coffee. Thank you. Bums and wees.
I was dropping out anyway, so so it seemed like fun to take the piss out of the system, sticking our two fingers as a farewell gesture.
Soulmate?
Yeah, for a while. But then when I finished the dissertation, she found herself another soulmate. Amazing, really.
That would be Richard Scott.
Yeah.
Who was stolen your laptop in Edinburgh.
So I'm told. You'd have said there wasn't enough evidence.
But the dissertation was on the laptop.
Yeah, along with two unfinished novels, a stage play, my diary, and a couple of dirty limericks.
Your diary?
Yeah, my Oxford journal.
That's something you were planning on publishing.
No chance. It was a bit, you might say, warts and all. I even named the warts.
Was there anything on there that could have led to Richard Scott's death? Or Amanda Costello's?
I suppose it's possible. I mean, it was a secret diary. That was the point. We have to know where to look.
And where should we be looking?
Ah, well, like the man said in the movie, follow the money.
Up the way. There we go, 10 minutes.
Do you still want those coffees?
Yeah, but not today.
Good choice.
Where are we going to turn?
Back to base. Forensics have come through with some interesting conclusions.
We know that Richard Scott was murdered on that night.
That was a really good clue, finding it sticking in his chest.
And now we know for certain that Amanda Costello was strangled using this string. And both weapons have identical traces of soil on them.
And Phil Bowman's a lot, then?
Not against him.
So, whoever stabbed Richard Scott was Ryan Garnett, perhaps?
I suppose it might be him.
Who takes a piece of string to a first night party on the off chance of needing to murder someone with it?
This is the icing on the cake. The two quotations from Shakespeare that we found next to the bodies were both written on an old style time island with a carl and ribbon. But he never locked his room, so anybody could have used it. We need to talk about the golden. Get her tape on cheating away to a doctorate. Ask her about their ex soulmate.
What?
I think we're being too nice to these kids. Should be behaving more like coppers. Shake their tree, see what drops out.
I hope it's important. I'm missing an agent for nothing.
We're investigating two murders. Shall we walk together?
Have there been two murders?
Here's my big story. I don't give a toss about my doctorate or Oxford University. If this agent comes up with the right deal, I'll be out of here by the end of the week. All right.
You get the gist. Thank you for sparing the time.
He's gone frightened with the children.
Oh, Sergeant Nicholson. Yeah, thanks for getting back to me. Listen. A simple question. A couple of years ago, when you were down here in Oxford, you were called out for a domestic incident. A couple of academic.
Fuck off.
Teaching, most unlikely.
Will you look somewhere else?
I think I can get it.
You hope so. Professor Gregson.
It would be foolish to deny it.
Perhaps
you'd like to tell us what you've been doing here.
While Sergeant Hathaway does his duty and searches the toolshed.
I suppose this is the moment when I say I can explain everything.
I hope you will.
It's very simple. I borrowed some secateurs from Phil to prune the roses in my garden. Decided to return them in person.
Phil Beaumont lives at your house. Couldn't return the secateurs after breakfast.
I know, it sounds illogical, but...
Was this a sudden impulse, or more premeditated?
You've lost me there?
Well, did you decide when you got up this morning, this afternoon, I'll return Phil's secateurs, and therefore take them with you to college? Or did you decide much later? Maybe Emma called, say we were going to search her house.
What? You sound so like a policeman.
That's because I am a bloody policeman.
Tell me, what's more, I think we were meant to find him.
Shall we start again?
You're the bloody policeman?
I am a policeman, but I'm operating on a pretty short fuse, so be warned. I've put up with a lot of Oxford bollocks on this case. Theatrical jealousy, maybe sex, maybe drugs. But it isn't, is it? It's about one thing only. Your academic career. Emma Golding has just completed a doctorate here, hasn't she? Even though you knew it was Phil Beaumont who wrote it. Now Phil, who despises this place anyway, doesn't give a toss. Neither does Emma. She'll be out of here by the end of the week. Who needs academic qualifications to work in the theatre? Well, the only person that cares about any of this is you.
Is it wrong to care about my students? I probably thought that's a good thing.
You paid Phil Beaumont £5,000 to keep his mouth shut. That, I suggest, is not a good thing.
You've seen his bank statement.
Unfortunately, the whole story was in Phil's diary on his laptop. So when Richard found it, he realised he had right over a buck.
I hate to state the obvious, but I'm not the murdering kind.
Not to calling Sergeant Nicholson of Sheffield.
Who the hell's Sergeant Nicholson of Sheffield?
When you met him, he's a humble PC here in Oxford. He was called out to a domestic disturbance. Report from one of your neighbours. Apparently you went for your then husband with a knife. He being a nice liberal-minded Oxford don, decided not to bring charges.
Well, he always was spineless.
Let's assume that you murdered Richard Scott and Amanda Costello.
Why Amanda?
She was one of the family, one of your blue-eyed girls. She knew what you were up to. But that wasn't much of a story, was it? Bit of academic naughtiness. Maybe a couple of paragraphs on page 7. But the minute Richard was murdered, straight to the front page. She had a good, big story. She boasted about it, first night part.
All I have ever done is try to help my students.
If you like students that much, why try to implicate them? Why try to pin it on Phil Beaumont? Or Joel Myers, come to that. Those ridiculous quotations from Shakespeare.
Theoretically, if I were a murderer, I'd do all I could to implicate other people with basic common sense.
What happened to Beaumont's laptop?
It's in the river.